My name's Trevor, and I want the Earth to last forever, so stop the use of gas and let the Earth last.
My name is Owen. I want to keep it snowing, so keep our heat stable, and we can keep making snow angels.
To stop the melting ice caps, to make more ice on the maps.
I am Izzy. I see the world transform, weather changing every day.
I am Ruby. I notice the storm's nature is shifting its ways.
Decrease the CO2 in the air to stop your pollutant and start your reducing.
Hi everyone, my name's Parlene. I like the world so green, so stop cutting down all the trees and start attracting all those bees.
I don't like oil companies that are greedy. Drill, drill, drill is what they say. Clean, clean, clean energy should be the future way.
My name is Ryan. We are concerned about climate change, and we're not lying. If we're not going green, we're not really trying.
We're Anna
and Gabby. We really hate the trees are dying. With every choice, let's be aware. Say no to waste, show that we care.
Welcome to Glenview United Methodist Church. We are Beth and
Greg,
and we are the co-directors of Family Ministries at GUMC. We welcome all who join us for worship today, both in person and online.
Today's service is brought to you by our GUMMY youth and what they learned and experienced at this summer's Climate and Faith Youth Summit, inspired by the SALT Project's Climate and Faith Devotional.
As people of the earth and as Christians, we are called to love the world and put our love into action. We are called to care for creation and pass it on to the next generation better and healthier than we found it.
The peace of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And also with you.
Please share the Lord's peace with each other. Stand up. Thank you. Let us pray. God of grace, restore us. Please raise in body or spirit to pray the opening prayer with us. Let us pray. God of grace, restore us to our calling. Grant us the love, courage, and wisdom to care for your creation. Help us to step back when we should step back, step up when we should step up. Strengthen us to act with generous gratitude so that life in all its wondrous beauty, from the waters to the wilderness, will flourish. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please remain standing. Open up the little black hymnal to page 2172 and join us in singing We Are Called. Thank you. Be seated. It is now time for the kids to come up for the children's message by the congregation Sings Kumbaya. Morning, friends. Hey, do you know what a horse is? Yes. Have you ever seen a horse? Yes. Do you think you would notice if a horse walked in the sanctuary right now?
A carrot?
You would bring a carrot to feed him? Yep. That sounds good. That sounds about right. Yeah? Yeah. How could you not notice a horse walking in the sanctuary? That would be kind of funny, right? Or weird. How about an ant? Do you know what an ant is? Would you notice if an ant walked in the sanctuary right now? I think I see one. Do you see it? I know, maybe just a few people would see it. But today, we're gonna talk about tiny things. Have you ever heard of a mustard seed? Maybe in a Sunday school class? Well, Jesus tells us, how big do you think a mustard seed is? Let me start there. How big is this? That maybe even a little smaller, Emma. I think that's about right. Yeah, it's really small. And Jesus says, that's all the faith you need. Because you know what happens? If you plant that mustard seed, do you know that plant can grow bigger than all of you? It can grow bigger than your parents. It can grow bigger than some buildings. And that's pretty amazing. Yes, Miss Emma.
It
doesn't. But you know what? You can use part of the plant. That's really a good question, because you can use part. There's a bunch of plants called, they're in the mustard family, and some of them make the taste, right, that we might have. You like mustard?
No.
Okay. I have one kid that likes ketchup and the other that likes mustard. Okay, but God says, just as that tiny, tiny seed can grow into this amazing, huge plant, bigger than buildings, that's what your faith can do, but it's got to start somewhere. And that's with believing in Jesus. Miss Emma. Not the bottle, but the plant. The plant. I'll show you a picture sometimes. Okay, it can be bigger than a building. So some of your older brothers and sisters in Christ back here, some of the youth group, they've been working on growing their faith. And one of the things they've been doing is learning how to better take care of the earth as Christians. We are called to do so. And they're gonna share some of that today. And so I think they've planted some seeds and it's starting to grow, and I think they're hoping to plant some more seeds today. So, how about we say a prayer to give them some courage? How about that? Think that'd be a good idea? Yeah? Okay, would you pray with me? Dear God, we pray that you'll help us to be the seed that grows to share your love with our neighbors each and every day. Help us to grow in our faith every time we meet someone, every time we have a decision to make about our changing planet. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, kids. I think Miss Susan and Miss Taylor are waiting for you back there. Go ahead and go back to Sunday school.
A reading from Genesis 1:28. God blessed them and said to them, "Be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky and over every living creature that moves on the ground." God wanted us to take care of the earth and not manipulate it for our own personal gain. This is important to me because we need to create a home where the future generations are not burdened by our choices.
A reading from Genesis 2:15-16. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work it and take care of it. And the Lord God commanded the man, "You are free to eat from any tree in the garden."
I'm not sure if this is either a memory or rather just a photo of me and my mom gardening and having this big caterpillar on my hand. Recently, this summer, we had a big plant sale here at the church, and we planted some of them in the garden. Some of my friends and I helped out, digging the holes and putting the plants in, and in the process, finding worms and such. This brought me to think about these verses, Genesis 2:15-16. These verses show that the human race was made to help and serve the earth, keeping it healthy and alive, and being a part of the creative process itself. So I was wondering, if that's what humans were made for, should gardening feel like a chore or a ritual? If it is a chore, then why should we do it other than it is our duty? Why should we feel obligated to do it? It would make it feel like a burden that we had to fulfill our role. But if it's a ritual, would it still be our obligation, or would we just do it out of free will? And would we find it enjoyable, or just do it because it is a ritual? These are all the questions that I asked and wondered about when I read this. But next time you're gardening or watering plants, just take a moment to think about how you're serving the earth and God.
Thank you.
A reading from Jeremiah 2:7. I brought you into a fertile land to eat its fruit and rich produce, but you came and defiled my land and made my inheritance detestable. Us humans have turned this planet from a place of living creatures and amazing views to extinctions, melting glaciers, and deforestation. We could start by reducing the amount of animal product we eat and start eating more plant-produced products. It is shown that beef produces the most greenhouse gas emissions. Eating less meat can help reduce pressure on forests and land used to grow animal feed. Skipping meat for at least one day a week can reduce your annual carbon footprint by as much as not driving your car for a whole month. This can reduce someone's carbon footprint up to 2.1 tons. If you're vegetarian or vegan already, you have produced 0.8 less CO2 emissions per year, which can have a dramatic impact on our own carbon footprint. If everyone started doing this, we could see massive changes in our greenhouse gas emission rate, which overall helps the Earth.
Let us pray. Dear God, give us the trust, humility, courage, and the hope we need to follow your word and guidance. Help us to be who you made us to be as caretakers of the earth, not for our sake alone, but also for your sake, our neighbor's sake, and the sake of all creatures, great and small, who don't have a voice. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
reading from Matthew 6:21. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. A few summers ago, my family went out west to visit the national parks. I love the nature and love spending time with my family there. I would hate the climate to see the climate change destroy the home we live in.
A reading from Mark 8:36. What good is it for someone to gain the whole world yet lose their soul? I'm worried about all the gas-driven cars and trucks. Cars and trucks are some of the biggest polluters. What good will all those cars and trucks be if we no longer have an earth that is safe to live on? We should all be trying to drive less and walking or biking when we can. If you're using cars to go to school or work or church, you should try to carpool whenever it's possible. This would reduce the number of cars on the road and reduce our pollution.
Let us pray. Dear God, maker of heaven and earth, father of love and justice, help us. Give us the strength we need to change our ways, to better the environments in which we live, not only for our own lives, but for our communities, local and far away, for our climate, for your creation. Make us humble, yet bold, so that we may follow when and where you call us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please rise in body and spirit, open your little green hymnal to page 3129, and join us in singing Touch the Earth Lightly.
A reading from John 2, verses 14 through 16. In the temple courts, he found people selling cattle and sheep and doves and others sitting at tables exchanging money. So he made a whip out of cords and drove all from the temple courts, both sheep and cattle. He scattered the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. To those who sold doves, he said, "Get these out of here. Stop turning my father's house into a market." This verse shows that just like the temple, the earth deserves respect and care. We can't ignore the consequences of exploiting the earth for economic gain. Big companies are abusing natural resources and taking for granted the nature that exists. The environment needs preserving rather than being used to make a profit.
Two. A reading from John 3, 16 to 17. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. I learned so much about the earth and how to keep it safe during the summit. We all need to take something away from this to save the earth.
Let us pray. Dear God, instill the passion and courage we need to clear away systems that destroy and to build ones that help us better care for creation. Help us discern when between righteous anger and compassionate patience is most fitting. Kindle it within our hearts for the sake of our earthly home. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please rise and embody your spirit. Open the little black hymnal to page 2153 and join us in singing, I'm Gonna Live So God Can Use Me.
Please pray with me. Dear God, help us tell the stories of your love and liberation in ways that open up new paths that show your love for us in the world. Help us listen to the earth to heed the signs of the times. Shepherd us toward a new way to a new land that could sustain all people, all of your creation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The hymns, reflections, and music we chose for today's worship service reflect what we learned this summer at the Climate and Faith Youth Summit and our calling as Christians to care for our Earth. Humans have been around for about 300,000 years. We've been massively polluting the planet for about the last 70. Over the last 50 years, we've experienced what's called the Great Acceleration, rapid and widespread increase in human activity and its impact on Earth's natural ecosystems. That growth has been driven by burning fossil fuels, such as coal, oil, and gas. The pollution from burning fossil fuels, known as greenhouse gases, stays up in the air for a long, long time, covering the Earth like a thick blanket, heating up the Earth. The last 9 years were the 9 hottest in recorded human history. 2023 was the hottest yet.
John 12:27 reads, "And what should I say, Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour." We know this is about Jesus, our Savior, predicting his own death. He had a troubled soul and considered asking God to save him from human death. As you heard in the readings from Genesis, God has called us to take care of the earth. This is our hour. Well, our hour probably should have started 50 years ago. The only real solution to stop this human-caused blanket around the earth is to reduce those greenhouse gas emissions that come from burning fossil fuels. We think that it should be a priority of our congregation to reduce as much of our pollution as possible. This will take us all committing to some changes and rethinking things, but we know we can do it.
In your bulletin, you should find an insert that lists 9 actions.
Four have a large effect on shrinking your pollution, shrinking the pollution we're adding to the blanket around the planet, and five have a small effect. Can you identify the four large effect actions? Turn to a neighbor and talk about it. See if you can agree. All right, if you chose using renewable electricity, eating a vegan diet, living car-free, and avoiding one long flight, you're correct. We know our church is already doing some things to help. We have not one, but two gardens that help to feed people in need fresh vegetables. This reduces food miles, reducing pollution, while encouraging more of a plant-based diet. We know we have thermostats that are controlled for heating and cooling, so we're not being wasteful while reducing our church's energy costs and reducing pollution. We have recycling bins, but to be honest, there's a lot going in the trash that should be recycled, and some garbage going into the recycling that makes the recycling basically not able to be recycled. As Gummy Youth, we are trying to help that this fall.
As a church and a community, we need more and more people talking about our overheating planet. We need more and more people telling climate stories about the pollution blanket heating up our home. We need more and more people talking about what can be done. Telling these stories is important because this overheating of the planet leads to more extreme weather. More hurricanes, floods, melting ice caps and snowpack, sea level rise, droughts, wildfires, and wildfire smoke. It leads to more people trying to survive in more extreme conditions, like more heat waves, toxic air, crop failures, hunger, thirst, poverty, disease, and extinct species. It leads to more unrest. Hungry, thirsty, hot, desperate people don't stay put. They search for a better life elsewhere.
This is the time, this decade, this is the hour when and where we can and need to impact a positive change for all who live on this earth. Like we shared, we need to reduce pollution. We need people in charge that care about our overheating planet. To do that, we need local, state, and national governments to support laws that create industry standards that would be required for all. But we are kids and can't vote yet. However, we did learn about something called our sphere of influence. We can tell climate stories to people who might be in our sphere of influence. That might be you or congregation.
On the back of the list of actions we talked about earlier, there are two questions. Your answers to these questions will help us figure out what our next steps, what our church's next steps might be. With regards to climate change, what would you like to see the church commit to doing that we have not done yet? Number two, what would you like to participate in or support with your time, talents, or financial support? Please put your answers to the questions in the baskets in the back of the sanctuary on your way out. The book of Acts talks about Paul's transformation. Paul went from persecuting Christians to following Jesus. Paul chose to be transformable. He chose to change. Change is hard, but it is what needs to happen. The choice is if we as a congregation decide it's too hard or if we are up for the challenge. Help us to make the world a better place, building on necessary changes. God is calling us to do this work, to take care of the earth, the home He gave us. It's our Christian responsibility. Amen.
Let us pray. God of all time, yesterday, today, and tomorrow, thank you for our earth, our home, our lives. Help us to follow you with courage. Be with us when we feel frustrated or troubled. Help us to trust in the work ahead, in the seeds we will plant, even and especially those whose fruit we may never see, but that will bless future generations. Guide and strengthen us to be stewards, gardeners, liberators, and celebrants you are calling us to be. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please join us in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Please open your little green hymnal to 3117 for Rule of Life.
Please be seated. I have a couple of announcements I want to share with you. Before then, what a privilege we have, these young people, not only leading the worship service, but also teach us and then show us how we move on. And I'm so moved and impressed. My hope is that they rent a big bus and travel to church after church after church, and teach them how we move on this climate change and crisis where we live. Not only climate and violence, all this, they lead us. And I'm so grateful for you that we let them lead us and the world. Thank you, everyone. I want to thank you. So great and so moving. The announcement I want to share with you, number one, is that next Sunday, please come back. We will rededicate our one of two gardens. We have two community gardens and one of them sabbatical garden. We will rededicate it. At the end of worship, we will talk about that a little bit, and we all go out to the garden and rededicate it. And number two, Barbara. Barbara has an announcement. Please come.
Hello. I just think we should really give them another big, big clapping because they're... I believe God is so happy and so excited with them giving this information to people. And oh, thank you. On September 27th to September 29th, we're having a fun, relaxing, and friendship-filled weekend for women 18 and above. Our presentation topic and discussion is the Book of Joy by Dalai Lama and Desmond Tutu. They spent a week together. The conversation centered on how do we find joy amid life's inevitable sufferings, lasting happiness in a changing world. Douglas Abrams was invited to their meetings to create a very special, encouraging book. Saturday afternoon is free time to relax, take a walk, enjoy friendships. It's near a lake in a beautiful place, and I've been there tons of times for many, many years. I love it there. It is at Edwards YMCA Camp and Retreat Center in East Troy, Wisconsin, about an hour and a half from Glenview. After the church service, I'll have forms that you can take that has more detail. Kathy Sawitz and Becky Netherland will have information also. How great is our God. Amen.
Offering plates are in the bag when you leave. You leave your time, talent, gifts, and service witnesses, and your financial support really support all our mission and ministries. And this is the benediction. Let young people lead our church, our families, community, nation, and the whole world. And we have hope, bright, bright hope. Go in peace. Amen.
You don't know.